passion. Give me one magnificent obsession. Give me one glorious ambition for my life, to know and follow hard after you. So give me one pure and holy passion, and give me one magnificent obsession. Oh, give me one glorious ambition for my life, to know and follow hard after you. Follow hard after you, to grow as your disciple in the truth. This world is empty, pale, and poor compared to knowing you, my Lord. So lead me on, and I will run after you. Lead me on, and I will run after you. So give me one pure and holy passion, magnificent obsession. Give me one glorious ambition for my life, to know and follow hard after you. To know and follow hard after you, to grow as your disciple in the truth. This world is empty, pale, and poor compared to knowing you, my Lord. So lead me on, and I will run after you. Oh, lead me on, and I will run after you. To know and follow. This world is empty, pale, and poor compared to knowing you, my Lord. This world is empty, pale, and poor compared to knowing you, my Lord. So lead me on, and I will run after you. Lead me on, and I will run after you. All I once held dear and built my life upon, all this world reveres and wars to own. All I once thought gain, I have counted loss, spent and worthless now to this. Knowing you, Jesus, knowing you, there is no greater thing. And you're my all, you're the best, you're my joy, my righteousness, and I love you, Lord. Now my heart's deep. righteousness my heart, and now my heart's desire is to know you more, to be found in you, and known as yours, to possess by faith what I could not earn, all surpassing gifts of righteousness.
You're worthy, you're worthy.
worthy, you are worthy, much more worthy than I know. I cannot imagine just how glorious you are. I cannot begin to tell how deep the love you bring. Lord, my ears have heard of you, but now my eyes have seen. Glory I give you, and glory I give, glory to the one who saved my soul. You found me and you freed me from the shame that was my own. I cannot begin to tell how merciful you've been. Lord, my ears have heard of you, but now my eyes have seen.
Beautiful one, I be praying for the House of Prayer movement in the nation of Mexico from Colossians chapter 1, verse 9 through 11. For this reason, we also, since the day we heard of it, do not cease to pray for you and to ask that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing Him, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might, according to His glorious power, for all patience and long-suffering with joy. Father God, we come before You this morning and we cry out on behalf of the nation of Mexico, and we ask God that You would begin to supernaturally establish Your houses of prayer throughout that nation. We pray that the praying church would arise. Lord, I pray for interdenominational rivalries, insecurities to be put down, and that the church, that the body of Christ would rally under the banner of prayer and intercession, worshiping You and ushering in Your Spirit into that nation. God, we are praying that You would establish Your houses of prayer in strategic areas throughout this nation, God, but especially on the border area, in the gated areas in which the crossings happen, God. We're asking for houses of prayer to be established, for houses of light that would radiate Your glory, that would shut down the agenda of darkness that is so rampant in that nation, that is coming across the border and bringing corruption on both sides in both nations. God, we are asking that You would fill this church with Your spiritual knowledge and understanding, that You would reveal to them strategies, that You would give them a prophetic voice in which they would declare Your word in this nation, that they would have an answer for the darkness that arises, that You would strengthen them by Your Spirit, that they would not go out in their own strength and in their own agenda, but they would hear from heaven and they would be empowered by Your Spirit to stand for righteousness, to hedge up a wall of protection for this nation. God, I pray for the people that they would respond. I pray for Your church body that they would rally under the banner of prayer, God, that they would understand that You hear their cries, that You answer their cries, and that You will respond to their prayer for their nation. You will release Your righteousness. You will release Your healing. You will release Your power as they cry, as they join together, unified under a banner of prayer. So God, we are asking that You would raise up and establish Your house of prayer in Mexico, especially along the border, that they would be strengthened with Your power and Your Spirit, that they would be given Your prophetic voice. God, establish Your house of prayer in Mexico in Jesus' name. A house that contends with darkness.
Right in Mexico, give her wisdom and understanding.
of U.S. Mexico, particularly in Juarez, El Paso. We ask you, look upon these cities with zeal in your heart. Isaiah 62, that you will set watchmen on the wall that will not hold your peace day and night in the city of El Paso, in the city of Juarez, until this city becomes the praise of the Lord on the earth. Lord, we ask you in the name of Jesus that you will build your own house of prayer, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. And you have given the key of the kingdom of heavens to your church to bind and to loose. So Lord, raise up intercessors in the name of Jesus all across the border of U.S. Mexico. Look upon Juarez. Look upon El Paso with zeal in your heart. Let them be Hephzibah, no longer a land forsaken. Let it be called Beulah. Lord, we ask you, a land that is merit. We ask you for transformation in those cities in the name of Jesus, because of the habitation of the glory of God upon the church, upon your people who cry out to you day and night. Intervene, break in the name of Jesus. City of fear, you will be called Hephzibah and Beulah. The Lord delights in you. Young men and young women will marry in the city. There will be rejoicing in the city of Juarez. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that the habitation of the glory of God will apprehend those who walk in darkness, that will arrest the heart of the most hardened sinner. Lord, we ask you, even for those who are involved in human trafficking, in drug cartels, Lord, in organized crime, apprehend them by your mercy, apprehend them by your grace. The suddenly of God break in. Father, we ask you, the connection that these dark lords have with the power of darkness be broken in the name of Jesus. We ask you to send angels to help those who are unto salvation in that city, in Jesus' name.
Time.
fire prayer for Mexico, and also small group prayer if you want to pray in the aisles. Father, we lift up this nation, God. We lift up this place, God, that's ravished by drugs and by cartels and organized crime. And we ask that in this hour, would you have mercy over that nation, God? Would you hear the cries of your people, those standing day and night and day, and crying out for justice? Oh, God, we ask that you would break in with speedy justice, that you would hear the cry for just the move of God, that your word would go forth with power and might, that you would demonstrate and confirm the preaching of your word with signs and wonders and miracles that would confound the minds and the powers of darkness, God. So we ask in the name of Jesus, would you rend the heavens over Mexico? Would you pour out your spirit in Jesus' name? Rain, God.
Suddenly break in with light. Oh God of justice.
Suddenly
break in with light. Send forth your justice.
Break forth power.
Suddenly break in with light. Oh God of justice. Suddenly break in with light.
Glorify Jesus.
Send forth your justice. Suddenly break in with light. Oh God of justice.
Would you resist darkness, God?
Suddenly break in with light.
You would push back, dismantle the oppressor in the name of Jesus. Fill your saints with light. Give them a spirit of prayer. Break in with justice.
Today we ask you, just judge of the earth, would you break in? We ask you today, establish justice in Juarez. Execute righteousness today. God, today as your body we bind. We ask you for the restraining of wicked men. Would you break in with your kingdom today in Juarez, Mexico, in the name of your son, Jesus.
Father, we ask that boldness would arise for those who would speak the word of the Lord prophetically, Jesus, just to the drug cartels and to the rebels in Mexico, in Jesus' name.
Father of lights, we ask that you would give your children in Juarez the gifts from heaven. Today, would you give the houses of prayer prophetic insight into what you're doing in their city, God. Give them revelation of intercession today, God.
Señor, abre los cielos sobre tu novia en México, Father. I just ask that you just pour your spirit upon your bride in the church of in Mexico, Father God. That you give them the strength, Father God.
Build your house of prayer. Gather your army.
be done in Mexico as it is in heaven.
Father, I praise your holy name that you watch over your word to perform it. Psalm 25:8 tells us, good and upright is the Lord. He instructs sinners in the way. Father, draw the sinners to yourself by the power of your Holy Spirit. Draw them into salvation and godly, holy righteousness. Raise up men of honor, men of valor. Thank you, Jesus, in your name I pray.
God, I pray for the house of prayer in Mexico. I ask you to come and root it and ground it in your love. God, let it be unmovable and unshakable.
Abba, Father, I ask you as your believers gather in Juarez and they sing and they pray to you that you would release Holy Spirit manifestation of Jesus from within them so that the light would shine into the darkness and the darkness cannot overtake or comprehend it. In Yeshua's name.
Abba, Father, we pray for your jealous affections to move in the border towns between Mexico and America. God, that you would do something significant today to turn things around. Would you strengthen your bride? Would you pour out revelation on those who are in the houses of prayer, God? Would you release the glory and the power of your name, lightnings and thunderings from your throne, O God? Affect the people in Juarez in Jesus' name.
Seigneur, je te demande de venir toucher les leaders et les dirigeants de Mexico. Seigneur, qu'ils puissent se tourner vers toi, qu'ils réalisent que ce qu'ils sont en train de faire, c'est mal. Nom de Jésus, amen.
Father, we declare this morning that your arm is not so short that it cannot save. And we declare Juarez, Mexico, to be a purchased possession of Jesus. God, we ask that you would raise your banner in that land and shine forth the glory of your Son.
Lord, your word says that the angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him. Lord, we ask for angelic protection for every house of prayer in Mexico. Lord, we declare that no weapon formed against them would prosper.
Intercessors. intercessor.
Hear the cries of your people.
Build your house of prayer. Build your house of prayer. Gather your army of intercessors. And build your house of prayer. Build your house of prayer. Gather your army of intercessors. Build your house of prayer.
Send a divine hunger, that you touch the hardest heart, soften hearts. Just speak to them, Lord. We just ask that your will be done in Mexico.
Jesus, I thank you for those that are being faithful to the call that you've placed on them to go to the deepest and darkest parts of Mexico. God, I pray that you would keep your protection on them, Lord Jesus, and give them strength to endure.
God, I thank you that Mexico is a key, even a key to our nation. I pray that you would, that you look at the IHOP fasting prayer teams, and they've spoken this word for houses of prayer along the border. God, I thank you for that, that you've heard, and that as they, that the house of prayer rises in strength, that you have a beautiful expression for this people, and that they would pray for the United States, and we will pray for them because we are in solidarity. We lift up the house of prayer to the Shekinah. Thank you, God.
Lord, would you strengthen the wall of intercession on the border in cities like Matamoros, Reynosa, Nuevo Laredo, Juarez. God, we ask that the house of prayer, that the wall of intercession would be established in Jesus' name.
Build your house of prayer. Build your house of prayer. Gather your army of intercessors. Build your house of prayer. Build your house of prayer. Gather your army of intercessors. Build your house of prayer.
Invite you to time a prayer for healing. If you have a need in your body, if you need healing, would you raise your hand, step into the aisle, we'll pray for you. Also, we're going to do special prayer for Kelsey Hayes, who is in medical crisis in front of the soundboard, and also Pam Stead, who's also in the hospital over here.
majesty, covered by your grace so free.
Here I stand, here
Jesus, found me just as I am. Empty-handed, but alive in your hand.
Majesty,
majesty, we adore you. Majesty. Yeah.
praying for college campuses from Isaiah 63. Father, this morning we bring before you just the plight on college campuses. As the most unchurched generation in American history is now in college, whose worldview is secular humanism, who do not believe in the absolutes of the Word of God, we ask that yet that you would break in with power and with might, that you would rend the heavens over the college campuses of our nation. We ask, where is the zeal of your heart? Where is the fire and the passion for who you are? We ask, God, that you would sweep across these campuses, that you would empower believers with might and strength in their inner man, that they would have the fire of God on their heart, that they would have zeal for your name, that they would be captured by who you are, by the beauty of your Son. We ask even now, as freshmen are preparing to go to college this August, we ask that you would create in them just longing and hunger and an appetite for the holy, that you would just bring them to the place of searching and questioning God as they go up to college. We ask for divine appointments in the first week of school, God, for freshmen to encounter fiery believers who have the word of the Lord in their mouth. We ask, God, for just divine appointments for salvations to come this August. We ask, God, mark freshmen. Save them, God. Set them apart for your purposes. Do a mighty work in this hour in Jesus' name.
Campuses in our nation. I ask you to fill them with the revelation of your Son Jesus. Lord, I ask you for experiential understanding of the affections of Christ. Lord, I ask you that you would begin to take them into long hours of loving meditation upon your word. Lord, I ask you to put your word in them like fire. Let it be like a hammer, like a sword. Father, when they open their mouths to speak about Jesus, classmates and dorm mates and professors are soundly converted at the word of the Lord. I ask you for the spirit of prophecy upon college students that love your Son. I ask you for words of knowledge, for dreams, for visions. God, I ask you to take college students in America up in the spirit, that you would begin to fill them with your emotions, your affections, that they would know what God is like, what he's feeling and thinking in the hour that we're living in. Father, I ask you for signs and wonders on college campuses where the activity is unusual of the Holy Spirit. God, where deliverance is taking place in cafeterias, in cars, at football games. Lord, we ask you to change the tide, God. Change the season. God, change the atmosphere on college campuses in America. Let them be centers of revival and sending to the nations. God, let John the Baptist be raised up and sent out into the spheres of society. God, we ask you today, we believe that you move today as we pray, that you would fill college students with the spirit of wisdom and revelation, the knowledge of your love for them, that you are for them, not against them, that the cross is sufficient. God, I ask you to fill them with revelation in Jesus' name.
Darkness, break in. 2 Thessalonians 1:11-12. Father of glory, right now, Jesus, I plead your blood over every college campus in America right now, God, that they would know that you are the real living God, the God who not only created them, but created the entire world that they know and love. And they would know that you desire their heart and that you have a plan for them, God. That they would know that you desire intimacy with them and that identity can be found in you, God. I just ask that you would pour out identity over every college campus right now in the name of Jesus. That you would rend the heavens and just come down and dwell with them in intimacy, God. God, I ask you would mark college students in America right now as burning and shining lamps, God, that would send forth your gospel, not only on their campus, but go to the nations, God, and cry out for you, Jesus. I ask you would mark people right now on college campuses, God, students as consecrated ones, God, that you would raise up Nazarites on every campus, God, that would forsake the world to know you, Jesus, that would forsake the world to know you, God, that would give them all the pleasures they've known and loved their entire lives, God, just to be close with you and know that there's an eternal man that is greater than any fleshy man on this earth. God, just break in right now and mark hearts with identity that they know they can find in you. God, I ask in the name of Jesus that you would just unfold destiny in the college communities right now in the name of Jesus.
Of your beautiful.
Ephesians 1:17. Father, you love college students. You love the professors. I ask that in your mercy and your kindness that you would visit them, God. That you would visit the ones who have given themselves to the enlightening of the mind, God. That you would break in, that you would enlighten hearts, God. That you would pull back the veil, God, over hearts, God. That you would bring many out of the kingdom of darkness, the kingdom of doctrine of man, God. That you would bring them into the kingdom of the Son of your love, God. That you would magnify Jesus. That you would give to them a spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of Jesus. God, for religion departments, Lord, I ask that this next semester that you would break in and on classrooms where there have been doctrines built around the man Jesus but are absent of true knowledge of him. God, I ask that you would break in with the spirit of wisdom and revelation, that hearts would be enlightened, God, but that many would see and many would believe, God, that many would be saved, Lord. Lord, I ask that in your kindness and your mercy that you would wash the feet, God, of professors, God. Wash the feet, God, of students, Lord, who have given themselves, Lord, to vain and empty speculation, God, that you would call them back, God, that you would call them and draw them to the truth, God, the truth of your word, God. God, that you would, in your mercy, in your kindness, God, wash the feet of professors, wash the feet of students. And in the name of Jesus, I ask that you would enlighten the hearts.
Specifically for historically black colleges and universities in the United States from 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 verses 1 through 5. Pray for us that the word of the Lord may run swiftly and be glorified just as it was with you. The Lord is faithful who will establish you and guard you from the evil one. May the Lord direct your hearts into the love of God and to the patience of Jesus Christ. Father, today we come before you again. We call upon your name. We know that your ear is not deaf, your hand is not short that it can't save. And Father, today we join in intercession. We pray for black believers today, those entering the school year this August. God, I ask you, let your word run swiftly. God, I ask you, let your word be magnified on college campuses today. God, I ask you for the establishment, for the setting and raising up of Christian ministries on HBCUs all across America. God, I ask you for a gospel witness on black college campuses. God, I ask you for leaders and student-led ministries. God, I ask you, break in today according to your word. God, I ask you, let your word run swiftly. Let the knowledge of your Son run swiftly. Let the revelation of Jesus Christ run swiftly today. Father, I ask you, release widespread revelation of your Son from your word. Put your word in the mouth of students. Put your word in the mouth of faculty. Put your word upon their lips. Let creation sing in praise of you to their hearts. God, I ask you, let your word run swiftly today on black college campuses. In the name of your Son, Jesus, amen.
Let your word run and be glorified.
17-21. In the last days, says God, I'll pour out my spirit on all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and young men shall see dreams, and your old men shall drink, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my men servants and on my maid servants, I'll pour out my spirit in those days, and they shall prophesy. Father God, we just come before you, God, for the college campuses of America. And God, we're asking for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, Lord. God, like we've never seen before. God, we're coming before you, God, for a whole generation of young people who are cynical, who says there is no God, that he doesn't do miracles, that he isn't alive. God, we're asking that today would you break forth in power and would you pour out your spirit on the college campuses of this nation. God, we're asking would you make yourself known as the God who heals, as the God who saves, as the God who delivers. God, we're asking that today, God, would you be able to make the witness of the Holy Spirit known. God, and the Christians who say, yeah, we just believe it in a gospel book, but we don't know if he heals. So God, we're asking would you pour out, God, just the healing anointing, God, upon your sons and your daughters, Lord. God, today we're asking would you pour out dreams and visions, God, where their friends was like, I woke up and I had a dream about Jesus. God, we're asking would you pour out your spirit today on the college campuses of this nation, Lord. God, we're asking for a revival, God. God, we're asking for power, Lord. God, that when professors say there is no God, God, that they would pray for a friend and they'd be healed. In the middle of class, God, we're asking would you contend with humanism, God, with the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. God, we're asking for words of knowledge, God, words of wisdom, God. God, we're asking that a professor who would be going through something and a student would have the word of knowledge and the professor gets saved. God, we're asking would you put your son on display, pour out your spirit on college campuses in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
King is exalted on high. I will praise Him. He is exalted, forever exalted, and I will praise His name. Exalted.
is you, and no, I
Just believe.